Now, one system that a lot of people would be expecting to see on the Commodore stand is, of course, the Amiga. It isn't on your stand. When can we expect to see it from Commodore in the UK?
Well, we would like to announce it as soon as possible, obviously. But we're not going to announce it until two things have happened. First of all, we have a very large range of software available in the UK. And secondly, we have adequate supply to mean that all of our dealers will be able to have the product off the shelf. We think that'll be probably January, February next year.
Hey, Nick, thank you very much.
Thank you.
One of the intriguing aspects about shows like this is not just the public face of the stand. This is Metacomco. Not on the face of it, a frightfully interesting-looking stand. But if you're among the privileged few, you might be invited into one of the hospitality suites. And if you're with us, you are among the privileged few. So let's go. And inside, we meet someone you might reasonably expect to see at a show like this, the Nigel Dempster of the computer world, our own Guy Cuny, together with something you won't see on the Commodore stand, the Commodore Amiga, and Dr. Tim King from Metacomco. Guy, first of all, why can't I see this machine on the stand of its manufacturers, for heaven's sake?
Well, it's a bit too wonderful for Commodore. They're a little embarrassed by it. They only have a Commodore 128 to sell in the UK at the moment, and they can't get this until nearly April next year, because we need a UK version.
So they're actually afraid of it competing with their own product?
I think they might well be, yes.
Right, what's the Metacomco connection then?
Well, when I got hold of this machine first, it didn't have an operating system. The people who were meant to do it blew it away. Tim King was brought in, I would say, as an emergency.
Well, Tim, as an emergency saver of the situation, you've come up with something which I gather is fairly impressive. How long did you have to develop the operating system?
Well, we've had about 6 months in total, but we brought out a first production development system in about a month.
That is motoring, isn't it? That's going some.
Without that, we wouldn't have the machine today.
Right. Now, you've seen it, and you've actually used the machine in the United States, and I know you're impressed with it. Why are you so impressed with it?
Well, it's not just the razzmatazz. When I first saw it, it's admittedly Andy Warhol was using it to draw a picture of Debbie Harry from Blondie. But apart from that, it is quite a special machine. It is more powerful than any machine I know. It does lots of things that other machines can't do, and it can do them all at once. Make it talk.
Let me tell you about multitasking.
Multitasking is the ability to do several things at once. But it can do several things at once on a level which other machines couldn't do just one of them. For example, that speech is built into it. It can type, you type things in, it will talk back to you what you said in a very convincing tone of voice, built into the machine. It's got a tremendously open thing. You can make it do quite sophisticated things with very simple programs.
We have here, for example, a very short program in our BASIC.
What have you got? It's about seven lines, isn't it?
That's right. And it doesn't look very exciting, but it allows you to do this by moving the mouse, pressing the button, drawing little pictures.
That is amazing. That's really very clever. And that's only an introduction to its graphics and its multitasking ability, isn't it? You've got something even more impressive now.
Well, the graphics on this thing actually boil down to what you'd call animation. It can give you genuine animation, not just a couple of slow pictures, one after the other. This is set up now to work with a mouse and icons, like an Apple Macintosh.
Right.
But it can also work with the old-fashioned command line interpreter. It can do both. And what I'm going to have done now is we're going to look through the disk here.
Yeah.
And we're also going to run a graphics demonstration at the same time.
So this is simultaneously two different things.
Well, that's the plan, yes. So, first of all, we ask it to look on the disk and tell us what it finds,
yeah,
what files are there. And at the same time as it's doing that, using the mouse, we run this demo.
Now, I have to say, those are incredibly impressive graphics. That really is animation, isn't it? The shadow and the noise.
Shadow and the noise. And that whole demonstration is using something like 10 to 20% of the power of the processor. It still has most of its processing power free to run your database, counts, whatever you want to run.
Oh, well,
and the other thing is, you're listening to the sound. You should listen to the music. This thing is Fairlight compatible. Fairlight's a synthesizer, and
yeah,
this thing can cope with the same waveforms. We feed them in through a MIDI interface.
Yeah.
Some of them are in already. We've got a flute and a guitar in already. And we're just going to play them, we're just going to synthesize, although this thing is capable of actually accompanying you singing or playing a wind instrument.
Have you ever heard me sing?
Don't sing,
right.
Just play it to. If you were a musician, you'd really be impressed.
Still, it was a good note to end on.
Thank you.
Everyone is talking about the Amiga, but very few people will actually get to see it here.